other one.
Yep, you too.
Good night, Mensch.
Good night.
So, you want to do anything?
I'll play instrument.
So that'd be a no. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, so here's a video I found. It's called Why America's New F-15 EX Eagle II is Feared Around the World. I can tell you exactly why. It's a better and cheaper F-15 Eagle. It specs are higher, and it's cheaper to manufacture by almost $200,000 per unit. It's more maneuverable, and every single part of it has been upgraded. And the F-15 Eagle has a 300 and some odd kill to zero loss track record, and now we're able to make more for cheaper that are better already.
There was actually a deal about that where one of our older aircraft got approved to carry nuclear ammunition as to somewhat as you suppose the other planes have.
Yeah. The F-35 Lightning II, which is a stealth fighter that is a multi-role fighter, and now it just got approved to be able to carry nuclear munitions. I personally approve, because that means we have fighters, stealth fighters that aren't quite up to code like the F-22, but are definitely good enough and could do rapid response with nuclear munitions, and you don't have to wait for a B-1 or a B-2 to deliver the payload. Mm-hmm. That being said, the upgrades to the B-1 Lancer, oh my god. It's a hypersonic jet that has not the volume of bombs like the B-52, but it has more bomb carrying capacity, like we're talking weight load, than the B-52. The B-52 has like 56,000 kilograms of weight that it can drop.
A lot.
The B-1, even though it is smaller, has 72,000 kilograms of bomb lift capacity.
What's the fuel economy, though?
Surprisingly decent.
Yeah, because thrust-to-weight ratio is always a big factor.
Oh, its thrust-to-weight is great. Because it never carries that high. It's designed... It has stealth coating and everything, similar to the F-22. So... Like, an F-15 Eagle, if I remember right, its radar cross-section was 15 for that tiny, you know, fighter.
Yeah.
This big-ass bomber that's a hypersonic bomber is a .075. So its radar cross-section is fucking stealth. And it's faster than the B-2. It's not nearly as invisible. The B-2 just won't show up at all. The B-1, it'll show up, but it'll be too late before you can do anything about it. And it's already gone because it's fucking fast as hell.
Say the interest in warfare, we're almost in cyber warfare, you know, like Gormangon kind of stuff.
Oh, we are already doing cyber warfare.
We are, but not to the caliber of Gormangon.
In some cases we are. We've been shutting down air traffic control radars and whatnot remotely, so that way a lot of our, you know how every military has their own integrated military system to where the overall data scape shows where the enemy is and where friendlies are. people have been using electronic warfare to remotely shut down and disable radar and communication systems to make dark zones, essentially, so that they can't see anything, and making it to where data doesn't show up on their datascape. So a lot of the high-tech, you know, aircraft out there that have that rely on these integrated systems to perform, don't have that information, which is why the F-35 is not exactly that great. You know what's funny about the F-22 Raptor? Almost all of its systems are analog. It's a nearly closed system.
That's impressive.
Yeah, it's why it's so fucking dangerous. It doesn't rely on a high-tech sensor suite or, a battlescape integration or anything like that. It literally... Hell, whenever the pilots are training, they turn off most of their high-tech gadgets and literally go in using old Cold War era analog tactics just to make sure that they still have the skill and the tactics to deal with not having the edge on information warfare. They train at a huge disadvantage. You know why, right? Exactly.
With some people.
Oh, it's not. No matter what, it's not fucking fair.
Shit, I finally won. I only had to play this guy 12 times. God, this deck sucks early on. I know it gets good.
anti-Stasi. You're more than welcome to join me if you want.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, so you know that military base that was to the west of our HQ?
Yep.
I'm having to assault it now, because that's where the next ammo truck spawned.
Those are all spawning on the high, just that being that little bit of past time.
Yeah, like into Noah.
Yep.
Yeah. So I decided to grab something. I decided to get an APC and bring that to the fight. Are you still able to hear me?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Oh.
My computer is starting to freeze up on Arma 3. It wasn't doing that yesterday. But my temp is not high. It's only at 86. My RAM is at 52%, so that's fine. And my GPU is at 57%. So there's no reason that this should be freezing up. Unless... my internet is having problems. Download's fine. With a 47 ping, that's good. Upload is also fine. What the fuck's going on? Thank you.
I've just got to send it. To whom it may concern. It's a bit formal. Hello there! Exclamation point. My name is Luke Carter, and I'm a fan of your collectible card games. If you've ever taken a look at my YouTube videos, you will know how appreciative I am of the merch that you've sent me over the years. So it was a great surprise to learn that there is a digital version of Inscription. I think maybe one of my fans pranked me and buried a copy in the woods near my house. Upon further research, however, I have not been able to find any record of this game. Is this some kind of elaborate hoax? Any trace of this game? Is this some kind of elaborate hoax? The game doesn't seem like the work of a prankster. It at least appears professionally made. I am both puzzled and excited by this discovery. Any information you can provide would be much appreciated. Thank you, the Lucky Carter. Okay. Good enough. Sent. Hey, card gamers. I'm the Lucky Carter, and this... Well, it's a bit of a strange video. It's actually more of a question to my audience. As I've learned over the years, nobody knows card games better than you guys do, so I'm hoping someone can help me out here. Did anyone ever play an Inscription video game? Or hear about it? I'm talking about that vintage one-set card game I opened packs for last week. I don't know what I'm allowed to say. I don't want to get in any trouble here. I think I've got the only known copy of the digital version of Inscription. I've been filming myself playing it, and it's weird, guys. I don't want to get in any hot water by showing the footage, but can someone please prove me wrong? Please tell me someone has a copy of this game. I have been looking online for days, and I cannot find a word about it. I reached out to the publishers, hoping maybe they would get back to me, but as a fallback, I got you beautiful viewers. Hopefully dig up something. That's it. That's the video today, guys. Thank you so much, as always. And, oh yeah, what the fuck is the card? Mr. Carter, we have received your inquiry regarding the digital version of our intellectual property inscription. I can assure you that no such software exists in any official form. However, if you have indeed come into possession of proprietary game Funa hardware, you are compelled to return it to us under the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act. The hardware will be considered stolen if it is not returned to us within a reasonable time frame. Please carefully package the hardware and paste the attached shipping label to the front of the box. You may mail the package at a local post office. We would like to avoid taking legal action in your case, so please do not delay in returning the proprietary software. Sincerely, Game Funa, Customer Happiness Department. What the fuck? I think this woman's actually from Game Funa. She came to my door yesterday, and I didn't answer. This time I'm gonna record it. Hi!
Hi there! Hey. I'm floppy disk for a game called Inscription. I was told you came by a copy of it somehow. Sound familiar?
No.
No?
No, I don't know anything about that. Inscription, you said?
Yes.
No, I don't think so.
Really? Because, apparently you emailed us about it. You are, Luke Carter, right?
Oh.
You know the luckycarter@gmail.com?
Yeah, you know what? That's, I am Luke Carter, but that's not my email address.
Really? Because, I just noticed because I've seen your videos.
Oh!
I'm a big fan.
Well. Thanks for watching. Listen, how do you know where I live, exactly?
My boss gave me your address.
And how did you get past the side gate? It's locked.
Okay, Luke. I'm going to give you my business card. And if you remember anything at all, feel free to give me a call. Okay?
Will do. Take care.
What the fuck?
Hey there, card gamers! I'm the Lucky Carter, and this is another pack opening video. Today I'm opening Secrets of Legendaria, hoping for that sweet, sweet foil Valamir.
Holy shit! I am so glad I brought this APC.
Why is that?
They did a counterattack. I basically have taken this base. I shelled everyone in it into straight up non-existence. They sent an MI-28 attack helicopter and two MI-8 transport helicopters. And I successfully survived. Oh, God damn it! Come on, quit freezing up! Why is it freezing up? It's not overheating. The GPU is not even under load. The RAM's not even under load.
You too. It's always right. All right. Thank you. Oh. There we go. What's that? Thank you.
Thank you.
his not a die off? Fuck. Actually, before we go, back to the air.
Thank you.
too. That's why I said do. Hey. Okay. The right cards. Somewhere I just don't get it. All push. Thank you. an eye out for that. I have a lot of marks. Yeah, that's perfect.
Those are broken.
Thank you. was even trying to...
Thank you.
I could have used it earlier. That's the digger they need. Thank you. shot. Or if they will replace. Up here. Part 3.